there, and yet it is not too jarring. So, office meeting, yeah, I've tried to do all sorts of things. Cultural reference irli anta Mysore Arman ela akombutide nan anse.
But this is what you use for your videos, Alva. Like, is this the same thing where you have like rapper tara tale boda
agira? Illa, that is you know, when this is off on the regular, like, you know, regular background. Just a second, okay. Sweet, I think we are live. Amazing.
Is it the same?
Yes, we are. Okay.
How? Oh, okay. Oh yeah, I see live button.
Yeah. A link el WhatsApp el kalsla if you want to share it on. Okay. Sweet.
Where do I share it?
Anyway, say for example, your Facebook, Instagram, atharena. So I'm gonna do the same.
I'll say link in bio.
Yeah. Okay, I see people coming in. Back, we can get started. For everyone joining, give us a few minutes. We are about to start.
All right.
So let's see.
Okay,
just a second. Done. Okay. I see. Okay, for people, if you have questions, illi neevu comment alli haki YouTube alli, and then we'll take it as we go. So before we get started, okay. And welcome to you all, starting with Rumi, Rupa, and stories. So, goodbyes are only for those who love with their eyes, because for those who love with heart and soul, there is no such thing as separation. To me, nothing summarizes better than the content Rupa creates, all sorts of content, and this is a Rumi poetry that I have liked. I did not know this was Rumi until a long time ago. So nanigid gotagidide when you started recently in Rumi month anta. So I'm like, oh, idru bage maatadbeku, and then I thought we'll talk about it. And then one day I saw the post, wait for it anta. So I knew something was coming. So I held my horses alli tanka. Okay, maatadana anta. So today we have with us the awesome content creator, storyteller, magician Rupa Rao, the director of Gantu Mute, the other love stories, Silent Passage, and now Dastak, and many more which I might not be aware of as well. welcome Rupa ma'am.
Ayyo, Vinay, thank you. Ma'am ella salpa overu. Thank you.
Right, so first things first, what was Rumi month all about? How did that
begin? Okay. I have been thinking, see, Instagram, I kind of like the idea of Instagram because it's a lot about images and it's short, you know, like if I let myself write, I can write pages, but Instagram challenges me to write within few lines. So that's how, I enjoy sharing on Instagram. And then I realized this is like, I share and like, you know, people who are like gracious enough to follow me, they like, they put comment, but there isn't much happening with each other interacting wise. So then I realized, I want to encourage people to write more because especially in the current times, we feel so less understood and we feel so less avenues to express without the fear of judgment. So that's, I thought, okay, so let's encourage, you know, like our friends and supporters in Instagram to share, write and share. So, and that's how I realized, oh, that's also Rumi's birthday month. So then I wanted to bring them together because who else can be more inspiring than Rumi to write for me, at least, right? So I'm a huge, huge, huge fan of Rumi. So then I brought them together and I called it as a tribute to Rumi and a poetry month. That's how it started. And we've had more than 100, 120 posts within a month, which is quite a lot. And a lot of them said they wrote for the first time and they felt really good. And so, yeah, it's been a great month. And for me, it was exciting to wake up every day thinking, what's today? You know, who shared today? And
right. Yeah. Well, were you actively writing as well? Pratidina Tinglali athava how did Dastak happen? The road.
Okay,
to
the... so I if you dig into my laptop and a lot of other books that are lying around, I have been writing since many, many, many years. So I didn't write new stuff this month, but I went back to my old stuff and saw what I can share, decent enough to share and in context. So, Dastak is something that I had written 4 years ago or 3 years ago for someone. And then I'm like, okay, so I kind of like the idea of reciting and performance. And Shweta is very excited about trying new things. And also, this is something she wanted to do too, like a poetry, you know, like just holding the whole thing by herself. And right. Just one shot. So we wanted to try that. And that's how Dastak happened.
Crazy. Amele, so Hangidre, when did Silent Passage happen? Was that written 4 years ago?
No. That happened during the lockdown. So I, you know, in the first 6-7 weeks when it was full lockdown, a lot of things happened in our minds, like to kind of understand what's happening, to perceive, you know, like this kind of, something such tremendous is happening in this planet currently, and psychologically, emotionally, a lot happened for all of us, right? Like the reconnecting and all of that. So I called a friend of mine who we hadn't spoken to each other. I don't know why, but we never spoke since 2017. And she's one of my best friends, and something just distanced us. And I called her. I texted her because Irfan Khan, when he passed away, I remember she was a huge fan of Irfan Khan. So okay. I'm like, hey, are you okay? That's how I started texting her. And okay. Then in like next 7th minute, I video called her. And it was so awkward to have a video call with her. And she lives 2 kilometers from my house. So that gave me this thought about Silent Passage, and that's how. And I had this thought, and I spoke to Rakesh because he was looking to do something within the lockdown.
Right.
And in 20 minutes, I wrote the script of Silent Passage, so that's how it happened.
Nice, because I think it was Rakesh's story to which you responded, saying this feels like an extension of Silent Passage, and you know, and to me, I felt it the same way. Yeah, right. Silent Jelly totally could have been an extension. And either way, this is just an extension of you, the writer, as well. Yeah, right. So it is not a total shocker, but yeah, good to know that 4 years ago, and then you realized it. And then working with Shweta for you, it's like piece of cake, I assume.
Yeah. No, not really, but yeah.
So, and then you just sent it and then you executed it. Is Shweta in Bangalore? Did you guys meet?
Yeah, yeah. She is in Bangalore, but I had sent this to her even before the whole idea of Poetry Month happened.
Mm-hmm.
I kept urging her if she wants to do this, if she wants. She's like, yeah, let's do it. But some things didn't come together. But when this Poetry Month context, you know, happened, we're like, okay, now we have to do it. So
right.
Working on logistics. So I wanted her to kind of do a selfie video of it and send. Mm. And she finds it very constraining to perform with the camera like that, you know, with selfie. So she wanted someone to shoot. And so I shot it. So it's shot in my phone.
That was awesome. I want to know more about the Nayana. Why is it that you only cast Shweta? But go ahead, tell me. But I also saw you both are twins at the rail. See, I've been a massive stalker about your content. So go ahead.
Ayo, Shweta, it's just, I think it's... I actually reached out to Spurti also, Teju also, during this. I wanted many, like even a couple of my other actor friends I reached out to, if they can do more. But just things didn't work out. But Teju, with Shweta, it's she's excited about new things.
Okay.
Others were excited too, but it was like timing not matching, you know, new kid. So a lot of logistical issues. With Shweta, also I can kind of put my... put down, like, you know, let's do it. And she's like, okay, yeah, okay, yeah, let's do it. Yeah, and we have certain connection that kind of helps, you know, like.
Right. No, for sure. Right. Then, nan obviously other love story na gantu mutte admel nodi didu. So, but you know, it is good to see that equation come back. Our sensibility, adella no, right? So, hange, for all the people who are watching online, which is 8, which is a lot of people for Kittak's reputation. So, notirarge, if you have any questions, feel free to comment only. But before I dig into your other projects, Rumi month again specifically, is Rumi, is he an influence? Atwa, have you explored him, his works, and bringing him to fiction? Atara, or what's your interaction with Rumi been like?
So, it all started to me like, you know, like, now if people have abused it on internet that any quote they say it's Rumi's quote, but you know how
about goodbyes and things like those. To me, I thought Confucius said, but clearly Rumi said it. But yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So I have Rumi came to me. I think when the whole Sufi thing was happening, you know, Teri Diwani and all these albums when it released, I resonated with that essence so much without even knowing what it is. And then I started reading up about it. And that's how Rumi came into my life. And ever since, I feel like maybe I could be a little piece of him. Just the way, so I have read a lot of books, his original work, you know, like not... that's internet good. Version.
Internet.
Yeah, and I've even tried to learn Arabic so I can read him the way he's written, but it's too hard right now to pick up a new language. So I really want to make his story with Shams of Tabriz. It's a beautiful story how Rumi, who was a scholar, became the Rumi that we know, like the eternal lover or like philosopher, however we want to call him. So it's because of his connection with this particular dervish, they call them, right? The dervish, like the Sufi saint. So they, because of their connection, Rumi happened. So I really someday I want to make that into a film. It's beautiful. There's a book called 40 Rules of Love, which is about their connection. It's Turkey and Middle East. I feel very kind of connected to that whole vibe for some reason.
Got it. Yeah. Illi, Ashika Kishore is asking, what do you love more, poetry or movies? No diplomacy, please.
Poetry in movies.
Or movies like poetry. This is Ganamute. To me, that
they're not any different.
Right. Yeah. No, I influence na to storytelling. For example, if someone has a philosophy or someone has tried to not preach per se, but talk about a philosophy. Do you think about bringing it to fiction content, say like movies, as against one narration do you think about bringing it to fiction, kind of dumbing it down in a way, you know, or maybe commercializing it or democratizing it a little more? Do you think on those lines?
No.
ಅಥವಾ ಇವಾಗ ಬರೀತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಏನಾರು ಬರ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ಸೇ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪೊಯೆಟ್ರಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಆ ಥರದ್ದು ಏನಾರು ಇದ್ರೆ ಆ ಜಿಸ್ಟ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆನ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕನ್ವೇ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಫಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಟ್ ಎಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆ ಥರ ಇರುತ್ತಾ
ಯಾ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ವರ್ ಎಡಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಗಂಟು ಮೂಟೆ ಐ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರದೀಪ್ ಅವರ್ ಎಡಿಟರ್ that this whole movie should feel like a Sufi song.
Sorry, do you hear the call?
Yeah, what is that?
Adhan and the FaceTime call bartade. Let me log out of that. So let's see. Sorry. Anyways, sorry, go on.
Yeah. So we already, I mean, for me at least, I have the essence and it happens definitely. Like for example, iruvudellava bittu iradudha redege tudivude jeevana, right? Mm-hmm. I red line itkondo, you can definitely, you know, bring a narrative around it.
Right.
There is so much that you can say.
So one, the like when you're trying to tell a story, when you're trying to make a movie at least, is that a thought process? Is there a need for that soul in any given story? Athara madadike?
Is there a?
Does it require to have a soul or a gist athara denaro?
Yeah.
See, it was so obvious, for you, but doesn't look like it for so many filmmakers. So many times it is mostly about what a great cinematography thing. And it has turned out to be that, Ivaga. Oh, great making. Amazing camera work. Movie. As again, telling a story.
You know what I feel? For every generation, there is something that we are deprived of. And when it is given, they celebrate it. So right now, I feel we are still in that space where, because we have been deprived of great making for a long time in Indian cinema, that now, we are still celebrating great making. Hopefully, we will move towards great story, you know, sooner than later. I hope. Like in European cinema, I keep thinking like they have moved in terms of storytelling to such, you know, like I think they're ahead of us, like 50 years at least. The way they just, you know, like Portrait of Lady on Fire, the whole thing is just about one emotion and how beautifully layered the whole thing is. But illi madidre they say nidde banbudti 20 nimshane yen maga astu slow ide kathe helta illa. So its taste buds are very different. Tumba biryani tindirovarge bere enaru kottak salpa kashta taste ar.
Right. So like on story, recently we did something called Reconnect ant adon short film madidre. And then that was an improv short film as well. So
with Ganesh, right?
Alala, ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ 4 ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಅಂತರ ಅಂತ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ರೀಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಇಬ್ರು ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್
ನೋಡಿದೆ ನೋಡಿದೆ
ಏನಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಟೂ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 10 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ನ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್ ಫಾರ್ 10 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಸೆಡ್ ದ ರೂಲ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 10 ನಿಮಿಷ ಮಾತಾಡಬೇಕು, ಏನಾರು ಮಾತಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಏನಾರು ಅಂತ. ನಾನು ಸುಮಂತ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಅದು. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಫಾರ್ 15 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹೇ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೂ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಅಂತ, ರೈಟ್? ವಿಚ್ ಇನ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಐ ಅಗ್ರಿ, ಐ ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೂ ಲಾಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೈಟ್ಲಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಅಂತ, ರೈಟ್? ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಟೂ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದೇ ಫೀಲ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದೇ ಫೀಲ್, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ವೆನ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಾಸ್ ಟೈಟ್ಲಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆರ್ ವೆನ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಾಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್, ಅಥವಾ ಟೂ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವೆರ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಆ ತರ ಈ ಒಂದ್ ಸೀನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಬ್ರು ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ 2 ಮಿನಿಟ್ ಸೈಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನತರ, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಶಿಯೇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ದಟ್?
It's a very tricky question because it's not something that you, it's not a grammar, it's an intuition.
Right.
It, you would like, and every work of yours is like you said, extension of you. It's just the way who you are, mm-hmm. right? So, and as a person, how you are, how many of your friends, like you, we don't do things to fit in. We are just ourselves, right? Mm-hmm. So even our work would be like that, I hope. I feel there is no way that you can, it's a rhythm. It's not like every fourth frame I'm going to cut it. Every 10th frame I'm going to, you're kid.
Hi, Elmer. Bye. Say hi.
Hello.
Amel Sigana. Amel
Sigana.
Okay.
Sorry, Kanda.
Go, goodbye. Sorry, but...
Oh, that was cute. Yeah, so there is no rhythm. You just know it intuitively. And not everything you do, people will accept. So again, there is an audience for you. You will, every kind of story has an audience and you will have to just find them. When you said, the people said it's long, I felt it was perfect. Because these things, like when two people after 10 years they're meeting, 10 minutes is even lesser time for them to reconnect. Like I can make like a 1 hour movie out of it. You know,
exactly.
Like, it's so layered. So people are very, I feel they're very uncomfortable with layers in especially Indian mentality. They just want it to be underlined and finished.
Yeah, then one of the comments, which is by a friend, she said, I could move from 4th minute to 12th minute and I would still get the gist of the story. Then I'm like, ನಾನ್ ಹಿಂದಿನ ದಿನಾನೇ ಟಿಂಕರ್ ಟೈಲರ್ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್ ಸ್ಪೈ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 7 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗೈ ರಿಟೈರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹೋಮ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಟ್ ದ 7 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಎಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಮ್ ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಪಾಂಡ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ, ರೈಟ್? ವಿಚ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಟೆನ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರ್. ಆದ್ರೆ ಬಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಸೈಡ್, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್? ಈಗ ಏನಾರು ಬರದ್ರೆ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಐಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆ ತರದ ಏನಾರು, ಅಥವಾ ಡು ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫೀಡ್ಬ್ಯಾಕ್?
ನೋ,
ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್.
ಬಟ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್, ಐ ಲೈಕ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ಐ ನರೇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಮೈ ಕ್ಲೋಸೆಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ದ ಎವ್ರಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನರೇಟಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾಲಿಂಗ್, ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೈ ಓನ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್. For right. me to know. So, and it doesn't work for me when I record it because I'm very conscious. So I have to speak it to a new person. And it has happened. Like I keep talking to my mom and 100 stories she must have heard and she loses the connect, but then she's at least gracious to listen to me. And my friends, like I just call them like, this is what's happening. And when I'm speaking to them, I'm hearing myself and I kind of know where what is falling. And about the rhythm, it's like, it's like love making, right? So when people say like, you know, story, if they are looking, it's like there's like Brahmandra manel uta madavaga ond 20 tara item haktare, right? 20 different items and everything is little. So you just get the taste of everything and then you finish. But then if you just get one bisi bale bath, you relish it. So you know, like, there is lavanga in it and chakke mogu. So I, that's what, like, they just don't relish it. They just want to get the gist. So there are other kind of movies to get the gist, you know, watch it. That's why I think people love thrillers and comedy, because they just don't want to give, just don't want it to be layered. Like, if you want the story, there is still story happening in those little lessons, you know, like you said, you know, when somebody is retiring and walking home, there's so much. See, this is because of this only in Gantu Mutta, I forced myself to write voiceover because I felt the need to explain what she is going through.
Mm.
Although I would have wanted to just not give voiceover at all for the whole film.
Yeah.
You know, because our large audience are like that, where they want to be explained.
Right.
And they want story to keep moving. So for them, you need to give. So our next movie, my protagonist is in silence.
Mm.
So let's see what people will say. Like, the whole movie they watched and nothing happened.
So voiceover and tandaga gantu mutali, the thought that came to my mind was totally the last few minutes. I don't know what feedback you got for that. Like, last 8 minutes, 9 minutes ali, when people thought movie was already over, and then there is a good chunk of very important content left in the film. Right. So I don't know what people said about that either.
It was a choice. Like, I knew it's when I'm writing, I know that this is, she cries after he's gone. And there is a night in the candlelight. She's crying. This is a craft, like, which I'm also learning. So there comes a moment she cried, like, while shooting. We were all in tears, like, that's how it was, so intense. But while editing, I had to take a decision to cut it halfway through. I didn't let her finish the cry.
Mm.
You know, like, I didn't let her go through that wave completely, because I wanted it to be half done. You know, she's not finished yet. After that, she doesn't cry. So this 8 minute of movie, that it was a risk that I had to take, because I know, you know, like, you hit the peak, you hit the peak. And then you need those 7-8 minutes, because this story is about her.
Right.
You know, like, we have established that. It's not about him.
Right.
The story didn't end there, you know. So this was a risk that I had to take. And I think it worked, because even every time I went to theater, people wouldn't get up after the movie is over. They're sitting.
Right.
So I'm like, okay, so they still want more of it. You know, they're just...
So, like, one of the friends, guilty of calling him a friend, but one of the things that he said was, oh, nan gotti tender on Saitan. So
very good.
I'm like, what a genius. So adre, I think up until the almost post movie adu primarily when people started exploring Gantu Mutta, when a lot of literature came out, I think news and articles came out, or even essays, avaga janak artha agididdu, it was more about her than and that it kind of reached a wider audience, Anta, right? So when you're telling a story like this, which needs a different perception, is there something you do to set that, hey, this is about her perspective, Anta? As well, have you done that kind of work, or is it like, hey, this is how I want to tell the story?
No, it's positioning. So when you are doing your PR, when you start telling people, hey, we are coming, from that moment onwards, it's... So there is something called NLP, you know, neuro-linguistic programming. So what you say 100 times become truth. So that I'm very conscious of the words we use during promotion. Even for the other love story, I didn't want anybody, be never in our PR material or in my interviews, called it a lesbian love story. I always said it's about two girls who are in love. So that's how I set the context for it. And it's about the 90s. It's about their love, you know, like, and for Gantu Mutta, I was very, very, very conscious of the female. Like, it's her story.
Mm.
As simple as that. So I think we gave it and people picked it from there. So it's important how you position it. And you position the way you are seeing it.
Mm. But tell me more about that. what's the difference in calling it a lesbian story versus two girls fall in love? Yeah, is it sexual? Is that
no, it's about the if it is a like in these tags and names, I wanted to come out of that. Because when these two girls in the other love story fall in love, they don't even know these tags and names, such terms that existed out there, right? So I wanted how it happened between them. It's about two people who just fell in love without questioning it. So it's later, like these tags, names, what it does is you already have a certain notion about that tag, that name in your mind when you're watching it. So you're coming with a notion. So I wanted to create a different kind of notion. I mean, I'm telling you already that this is what it is. So how you are going to come and watch, I want it to be a little more unfiltered in the sense. So these terms and these tags, we all have, the moment you read it, like for some, it could be an aversion. For some, it could be a like you've watched, you've read these terms in pornography, lesbian something. So when you enter, that's what you're thinking and coming, right? So I wanted to kind of break it all, even when, keep it as simple as what it is.
It sort of goes against the intuitive thought, saying that, like, say, if I want to tell a lesbian story, then I would rather say, I want to say it's a lesbian love story and then show nothing pornographic. And then define that this is called lesbian love story as against, oh, pornographic idre matra lesbian story. Wouldn't you want to fight that? Or is that outside the scope of the film?
Yeah, that's not my fight to fight at all. It's for all those who just want to see a love story. Not for those who are watching pornography and coming here for something. It's not, they are not my audience.
Or even for the people who want to be politically correct, Atwa, who want to understand, like my thought process that I was explaining. Right?
Could be.
So as a writer, is it that you curb these other thoughts, Atwa? Do you just, when do you filter it out, these other thoughts, if at all they show up?
No, when a story occurs to me, I sit with it for so long to see what about it is occurring to me. And then when I know what about it, I underline it, I keep the essence somewhere and lock it and leave it. And my entire journey with that story will be to see if I'm being truthful to that essence. So with the other love story, it was about just two girls who fall in love. This was my essence. And for me, it was more love story than two girls. So it didn't come to my forethought at all when I started thinking about the story. So when it didn't come to me, why am I going to underline it? Right? What came to me was their love story. So I underlined, kept it. And then my whole journey was to see how am I telling their love story, not about their struggle as a lesbian couple. Or that was not my spectrum of thought at all. So with every story, that is what I do. I sit with it to see what about it is coming to me, like the essence in it.
Got it. So, like when you were talking about essence of that, right? What's the essence, if at all, if someone has to take for Dastak? I don't know how, like, feel free to talk about it too. Like, I know it only came out yesterday, Alva.
Yeah.
Or the day before.
The essence of, when I was a teenager, I used to feel like, because I was movie fed, that love stories become complete when two get married,
right?
Lived happily ever after. That is what we learned. And then I realized, I questioned it when I was in PU, that how is love finds a completion in marriage? I never understood that, right? So when I questioned that, I realized, and then as I keep moving in life and when love stories happen to me, that story relationship might get over, but not love, right? So there are two very different things. So when I wrote this, it was about that moment when, this person is coming back after separating for a couple of years. Now, when the person is coming back and we are in different situations where we can't, there is nothing that we can do about it. But you feel so vulnerable that you want to do something about it.
Right.
So that is where it came from. unrequited love, it's going to stay like that forever.
It will. So to me, that was exactly none other. Like when I watched it, that was exactly my thought, right? On one hand, I wanted to know that universe. Mickey details ela miss agoyitala anta nanige amel on the other hand, if I just related to things that I look at the story from my perspective, then I have a story by myself. Like I don't need the rest of the story of either the writer or the performer or how they performed and things like those, right? So it's to me, that's one of the reasons why I loved The Sucking. There were two dimensions. It's like,
yeah.
I could live it or I could be superficial and then say, I'm like, Indian, I don't care. Yeah.
Story na irlappa yenadrolagade.
Like whatever it is, right? It's like, why would someone say something like that? Yes.
No, I'm just saying from the audience, you know, there could be that audience. Yeah, naito adrolaga arthane aglilla nanage.
Exactly. Part 2 martira, Dastak 2.
That's
like a horror film.
Yeah, that's what I was just about to say. There was a movie by Sushmita Sen called Dastak.
Okay.
One creepy stalker, beautiful songs.
Mm.
So that movie came to my head, like Mahesh Bhatt direction.
How I forget that guy's name. I know the one fantastic song, Dastak, in that.
Tumhe kaise main bataun, tumhe kaise main kahun.
No, I don't know, but maybe, yeah, totally blanking out on that. But yeah, Dastak 2 would be a horror story, yeah, right?
Sure.
So through making of all these stories, there are too many horrors that you go through. Will you make a horror film too?
No. I won't, because I don't watch horror films. I don't feed myself with that emotion at all.
Mm-hmm.
Totally unnecessary for me, because if I want to watch horror, then I'll put on TV news channels these days. That's how it's come down to.
But you know, like, so do you tie yourself down to a certain kind of storytelling? If you say,
no, I'm
never going to do horror.
ನೋ ನನ್ಗೆ ಹಾರರ್ ಫಿಲಂ ಜಾನ್ರ ನಾನು ನೋಡೋದೇ ಇಲ್ವಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ನನ್ನ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗೋದೇ ಇಲ್ವಲ್ಲ. ಸುಮ್ ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಲೈಕ್ ಇರ್ಲಾರ್ದೆ ಇರ್ವೇ ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ತರ ಹಾರರ್ ಫಿಲ್ಮ್ಸ್ ನೋಡೋದು? ನನಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಲೈಕ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಐ ವಾಚ್ ಇಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಐ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಮೈ ಓನ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಒಂದ್ಸತಿ ಯಾರ ಜೊತೆನೋ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದ್ಸತಿ ಐ ವಾಚ್ಡ್ ಗ್ರಟ್ಸ್ 3. ಸೊ ಈಗ್ಲೂ ಕಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಳೆ ಕೂತಿರೋ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಯಾರೋ ಕೂತಿದಾರೆ ಅನ್ಸ್ತಿರತ್ತೆ ನನಗೆ. ಸೊ ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮೈ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ವಾಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಐ ರಿಯಲಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೈ ಸಮ್ ನೈಸ್ ಲೈಟ್ ರೊಮ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಡೂ.
ನೋ, ಯು'ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಲಾಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಶಾಲೋವರ್. I think you are incapable of doing that. But
I think so.
But yeah, no, you have to stop way early in your thinking process. So, but on the other side, right, and I want to talk about what's happening, say, UP incident and things like those too, right? Socially, a little more relevant. Are you going to talk about those? Because the reason I ask you this, as a storyteller, as a filmmaker, you are in a place where you can influence people to a certain kind. Depends on yathara movie martivi yathara anta. Do you feel the urge to tell a story based off of the current incidents that happened, either the UP kinds, Tatva Nirbhaya athara dirbudu, or in general? This is something that I've talked to you as well. Then I know say. I forget how, you know, what is that called? Igeno hudgirna dagara dagara anta annadu, right? You addressed in gantu mute, but there is a certain lifestyle that exists today in general, which the everyday impact agadukku atho one strong incident thing aitu annadukku. Do you feel the urge to tell a story about such things?
Yes, I do feel the urge for sure, because I'm... there are like my mom works for child welfare department, women and child welfare department, so I've read, I have heard, I have seen, I have met victims and various kind of stories. I'm sure these must have been my push then to leave Infosys. And so that was my push then, like, you know, these stories need to be told. But then I also know that I don't want to say it. See, like the acid victim story that came with Chapak that came. Very certain kind of audience go watch it. You know, the moment you kind of say this is about this, very few kind of few or like already we have less audience, and then the audience go more like, you know, even lesser. So I want to see how I can bring this. Like, for example, in Gantumute, there is child molestation that we have subtly mentioned and how it impacts her. So I think that's how I think I want to integrate it into my storytelling. And I want to say it, convey it, but then it should also not become like, you know, like I don't want to lose audience because it's all about that. You know, rape victim kathe ante kano hogala. Yeah, yen nadiyodane yen nododu. This is how audience think, you know. So I want to figure out a way to definitely tell stories of current scenario, but I don't know how. Like, I need to figure out, because it definitely bothers, you know, like just putting up a Facebook post or an Insta post will not suffice. Like, I have written pages together. It still burns my blood when I think of what's happening. But, you know, we need to see how to leave a better world for next generation.
Other with the kind of cinema that Andre, I'm sure really for another point, someone, Prasanna Acharya said, that's an overgeneralization of Indian audience, Rupa. But this is about, you know, about art film versus our conversation, where people don't.
India is 130 billion people, so we can.
Yeah.
130.
You can sort of generalize. You have a lot of data, so you can generalize, right? So that's fine. Adre, but I'm on in terms of cinema. When it becomes cinema becomes an escape mechanism, alwa jana. Movie nodade, I have lots of problems in my own life. I don't want to go watch another movie about a rape victim. When that happens, what's the escape from that world? Is there any?
No, the thing is, again, you know, 130 crore population. In the world, it's 700 crore population. So, one is, of course, movie needs to be watched.
Mm-hmm.
Only then it attains completion. Another is the urge to tell that story. So if you have that real urge to tell, and if you are keeping it as real and pure as possible, then it will find its audience. 700 kotiyalli 70,000 jana nodalva. That's how I approach my storytelling, like whatever I want to do. Like, ishtu jana idare idrolu ondashtu jana nodalva anno one mindset alli I go. So those who India as a country, yes. See, I was thinking some 12 years ago with a friend who is from Ireland, and we were figuring out in India we live the real life, and people watch movies for unrealness so that they get an escape, like you said. Again, overgeneralization, but then majority, I have data, like majority of them who buy ticket and go watch in theater, they are different kind. And in the Western, like the other parts of the world, people live certain kind of unreal life compared to India, because they are privileged in terms of their fight is not to find 2 meals a day. You know, their fight is to find I don't know, like psychological different kind of fight they're all fighting, because government largely takes care of their basic necessities, whereas in India it's still a fight. So they go watch movies, even if it is, they watch it for realness. So it's a different kind of audience, and we need to find our niche audience within India to see if we can still make a film about, let's say, a rape victim, and we still reach out to them. So why do I want to tell this story? I need to be very clear of it. Like, because movies are documented proof. I'm leaving this for generations to come to refer to, you know, like you're kind of projecting the world you're living in a boxed space for them to watch it. So you need to be very, it's a very, very responsible medium. So you can't just glorify everything, you know. See, I keep thinking like, if I were to ever shoot a scene which is as gory as it was like in the newspapers that we read, I don't know if I will ever do justice to it, you know, because imagination is always larger than reality. So I might just end up adding many things that didn't even happen, you know, like in real. So it's my challenge as a storyteller to keep it real. We'll see. I don't know. I'm just going in the flow.
Yeah. See, on that front, like on another podcast I was talking about, Ali, we were talking about kind of giving scale to ideas. Like in that podcast, we were talking about sustainability in business but we were talking about that's a way of life and things like those. How do you bring that as culture to companies? I mean, how do you give that scale? Like, for example, hotte tumdavar idinella maatadabodu, right? The values and things like those, atharella for people who are struggling to make ends meet, for them, they're not going to think about values and such, right? So, or even for that matter, some people who struggle is day-to-day life on ashta idre, why will they think about things outside? And so that's where the escapism comes from. So the likes of Raju Hirani's films and things like those, Nodadaga, where there is a central idea of don't run behind in academic excellence and other like that. So that's a great idea, Nan Prakara, but not a big fan of Raju Hirani and his kind of filmmaking because it dilutes a lot of things personally, right? So, but on the other hand, when say you filmmakers meet, I don't know how that is, if at all you guys meet, or even other filmmakers who are your potential friends, if there is a slight chance for that. So if you guys meet and talk about it, do you talk about such things? Hey, how can we dilute down, or is it mostly about telling the stories?
I haven't hung out with a lot of other filmmakers, so I don't know. Only other filmmaker I very regularly hang out is Sahadev, who's also my business partner. So, and we are very, very similar people. So there is no argument about you. I think everybody is in there. See, Capernaum, I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. There is a movie that I watched. Have you seen it? Capernaum. I wrote about it on Insta. So it's about a kid. I think it's a Lebanese movie. I'll share it. So, such high drama movie, but it's so simply told, you know? Like, there are many, many moments where I teared up. And it's so simply narrated. And that is the kind of stuff I like. Iranian cinema, like when we watched Children of Heaven, or, you know, because life offers such drama.
Right.
So that's where I am heading. If I'm, you know, in my own exploration. So to each his own, and everybody is making films for their own way, in their own clarity. So I haven't had that kind of discussion with other. I mean, I have met very few filmmakers. So I don't like the.
Yeah. Got it. So I'm sure a lot of people reach out to you as well, who want to be filmmakers, who want to be writers, and then some talentless actors might reach out to you too. But for writers and filmmakers, do you tend to talk about films and things like those? Atwa, how is that conversation for people who want to reach out to you? How does that happen?
It had happened once that somebody called me. They got my number from somebody, and he said, I'm an assistant director. I have a script ready. I want to make a film. I said, okay, why do you want to make a film? That's where my conversation starts. Like, why do you want to make a film? First, let's talk about why, and then we'll talk about how. and that why will tell me if I can, I, you know, like if there is a connect with that person or not, for the way they would answer. Most of the time, they'll end up saying, no, I want to get popular, or like, I want people, you know, like, it's such a dreamy world.
I want to learn using red camera. How about that?
Yeah, all kind of answers come like, okay. So you would know exactly how this is going to go the day, the moment you ask why. And then also, I don't know what I can offer other than just talking about how it has been with me and how I see films. Other than that, I don't know what else can I offer. And if they are okay about it, then we just talk about it and whatever comes out of it.
You're right.
You know, like, there is no, again, syllabus for that.
Thankfully. So every director or every storyteller can tell a story of their own, which is their version. And then as long as you can bring yourself to the story, I think it is okay.
Even if you're lying with such conviction, reality, that people should believe it. That's what I feel like. There was a movie called Jayam, right? There, it was completely commercial movie, but I love that film because everything about it felt so real that it could happen, because he kept the emotion so strong. It was a Telugu film. The emotion, it reached out to me, so it did do something to me, you know, like, even if they were fighting and all of that, I feel it could happen, because in Andhra Pradesh, in Rayalaseema, this happens. Like, you know, they are very rough in their, they are very physically, you know, like, they express it like that, is what I have heard. So it's not about, it's about just keeping it somewhere believable.
Mm-hmm.
Just make me believe in your world.
See, the culture, like, which brings me to another point that is running in my head always. Right? There is one that, okay, our part of the world alli jana hangirtare aa tara stories helbeku anta one realism idre. There is a soft way of influencing people. For example, all the hue and cry about Arjun Reddy or Kabir Singh was about how he was a masochist anta itto alva. But the director's version was jana hangirtare, have you never slapped your loved one anta eno helita, right, in one of the interviews. So where do you draw that fine line? Like, this is where you are giving it to masses versus, you know, you're just holding a mirror. Do you care? Not care?
I don't care. Holding a mirror is all I want to do as an artist. I want to show what happens. And in the way I have seen it, that's the only way I can show it as well, right? I am not a god sitting here to say this is right, this is wrong.
Exactly. Yeah.
So, I mean, like, people,
a tough call.
It is. It's a choice that you make, because this, you know, like, for everything now there is an argument, because now there is a free space called Facebook where people can argue. So, it's everything will have an argument.
Correct. Yelladukku there is moral police as well. So. ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಕಷ್ಟ
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ ಬೇಡವೇ ಬೇಡ ಅಂತ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ದ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಆ ಲೈನ್ಗೆ ಒಂದ್ ಸಾವಿರ ಸರಿ ತಪ್ಪು ಇವರು ಅವರು ರೈಟ್ ವಿಂಗು ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ವಿಂಗು ರೀ ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡ್ರಿ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಲೈಕ್
Yeah, so what are you, light, right wing, left wing, or just the one with wings?
I have a tattoo here which has two big wings. I want to be that flight.
No, I think your content speaks to that. At least I think so. Right. So you go, what's up next, if at all there is anything in the pipeline?
No. Let the situation. I feel like there is a certain rush here. I sense in a certain rush, especially in the cinema industry. It feels like
I was telling you to theaters open and all.
Yeah, but ad open adrunu henge yenu nang gotilla. I don't know. I want to just wait and watch. But actually, you know, like I was telling my mom how it all feels is like, you know, if you know old in childhood when you go to a village and that village has only two buses coming, morning one bus, evening one bus, and you've gone there for some temple, some self-celebration, all right? Mm-hmm. And there's like a lot of crowd and people rush to that last bus in the evening. Mm-hmm. Usually what happens, these festival celebrations, government would have given one more extra bus. Oppandada merege anta hakkonde they would come, you know, like on of special duty and that.
Yes.
So usually the second bus will be super empty because the rush is finished, right? So somebody asked me what I'm like, you know, what is your next plan? I'm just waiting for that next bus. Even if that bus doesn't come, I'm going to sleep in that village in the night and next day I'll see what I can do.
But as a content consumer, active content consumer, I have to tell you, he got Tenet release aadaga, theaters are open illi. So I did go and watch it in theaters, right? So,
wow. Okay. Yeah. How was it?
It was fantastic. Andre, to watch a movie in a theater. I'm a full-on movie lover. So, yeah. So,
but then how was it to watch it with other people in like the whole...
Andre, henge gotta vanda Ronalli, I think it was like RC10 itto anusute. Adralli ibridre, that was crowded row.
Okay.
Like, and it has to be the case, right? So, given our... idiotic president and all the people around him and all his supporters, adella bere idiye like. So with that in place, I think it was a good one. I'll hope, at least hogi nodadike I had a lot of fun, and hopefully if that is how much the crowd is, I wouldn't mind going back. So so that was it. As we wrap this up, there is another question. Do you think movies should convey a message?
I don't know.
watch rest of the interview and you will know, Prasanna. So that's exactly what we spoke about. But cool. Awesome. Thank you so much. Yeah. You jumped
Thanks,
on
this,
at one text message.
Yeah, because we've been meaning to do this and it's...
Yes. Yes, and more.
I just love the way you got excited about Dastak, so I was like, let's do it.
yes. No, I loved it. I hope more people watch it. So good luck for that and all the good things. We'll talk more.
Thank you.
Say yes. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Bye-bye. Thanks, Anai. Bye-bye.